Welcome to the President's Diary, where we take a look at His Excellency Dr. Mohamed Irfan Ali's week of activities. His Excellency started his week by joining thousands of Guyanese at the National Stadium on Sunday night to witness and celebrate the Guyana Amazon Warriors as they claim their maiden title in the Caribbean Premier League.
A 10-year drought has finally ended for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Off the back of Sai Mayuba brings up another half century. Starting back in 2013 when they got to the final. 11 years into their run, they can finally claim to be champions of the Republic Bank CPL.
The head of state who handed out the medals to runners-up, the Trinbago Knight Riders and champions, the Guyana Amazon Warriors, spoke about the importance of the tournament in promoting Caribbean unity. President Ali held a bilateral meeting followed by dinner with the president of the Islamic Development Bank, ISDB, Mohamed Suleiman Al-Jasser, at State House on Monday evening. The ISDB head discussed the bank's involvement in the country's development. During the engagement, the president highlighted his government's vision for 2030 and beyond. President Dr. Irfan Ali and First Lady Aria Ali were issued the first two Master Black Cards from the Guyana Bank for Trade and Industry, GBTI. The cards were represented by GBTI CEO James Foster and Deputy CEO Sean Bucharan. GBTI Master Credit Card users will experience exclusive benefits when traveling or shopping at MasterCard partner merchants around the world.
On Wednesday, President Ali attended heritage celebrations at St. Ignatius, Region 9.
The president underscored that his government aims to completely modernize Upper Takutu, Upper Essequibo, Region 9, while protecting its cultures and traditions. He emphasized that the region's culture will not only be protected, but used to create a strong ecotourism product. He also committed to building the required infrastructure and train and invest in the needed human resource capacity to ensure the viability of the tourism product.
President Ali and senior members of his government held bilateral discussions with Saudi Arabia's Ministers of State for Foreign Affairs and Climate Envoy and his team.
During the discussions, President Ali spoke about investment opportunities in the country, infrastructural development, renewable energy, agriculture, the oil and gas sector, and economic cooperation. Additionally, the head of state recently met with members of the Howard University community, including the university's president, Ben Vinson, at the Frederick Douglass Memorial Hall in Washington, D.C. The nine Guyanese students, Lakeisha Henry, Ryan Duff, Ozioma Scott, Keith Court, Aaliyah Anthony, Mariah Hamilton, Kayla Vanderstoop, Kayla Ford, and Amir Innes, as well as other members of the Caribbean Student Association, welcomed the president to the campus.
The president addressed the student body as the future leaders who will address important global concerns, including artificial intelligence and plans for net zero greenhouse gas emissions.
President Dr. Irfan Ali highlighted Guyana's commitment to shaping global conversations on critical issues that are paramount to the development and sustainability of today's world. During a broadcast hosted by Atlantic Council in Washington, D.C., the head of state spoke about Guyana's emerging role as a leader in energy, climate change, and food security. He emphasized the country's focus on championing forests and carbon markets, reducing food imports, and becoming a regional food hub. President Ali received a visit on Friday afternoon from Andrea Savitsa Ogle, the recently appointed judge of the Civil Court of the City of New York, USA. Judge Ogle, who is a Guyanese-born American, is originally from Berbice and is the first Guyanese to be elected by the Queen's Democratic Party, chaired by Congressman Gregory Meeks. President Irfan Ali hosted a Rotaract Club of Georgetown's blood drive at State House on Saturday afternoon. The drive was organized in direct response to the National Blood Bank's current shortage. Through the drive, the Rotaract Club is aiming to secure the donation of 100 units of blood.
This was the President's Diary, where we took a look at His Excellency Dr. Mohamed Irfan Ali's week of activities. Thank you for watching. You join us again next time.